Hello, everyone. I've just come from doing my weekly food shop. And I have three bags here. But I tell you what, I might as well throw one of these three bags straight into the trash. Because globally, we are wasting a third of the food that we produce. That's right, one third of our food is wasted. But I'm not going to waste anything today, and you could probably tell that already. But let's take a look and see the types of food that we're wasting on a daily basis. What do I have here? A loaf of bread, some fruit, some veg. You know, I'm on a bit of a health kick at the moment, and some pickles. And my partner loves them. But by wasting a third of the food that we produce, we are effectively telling farmers to grow more food than is actually needed, and by virtue, creating even more environmental harm, because we are wasting the water and the land used to grow our food, a waste of the fuel to transport it, and the electricity to store it. So when we're wasting food, it isn't just that plate in front of us, it's all of those emissions that have gone into producing it. Take a slice of bread. You know, I'm sure we've all wasted a slice of bread at some point in our lives. I know I certainly have. But what are the resources that go in to producing it? How many emissions are created? And let's find out. I mean, first off, to produce this slice, we're going to need to convert some woodland into farmland. We're going to need a patch of land about 700 centimeters squared, the size of a box, to grow the 60 grams needed for this slice. That's already 38 grams of CO2e. Next, we're going to sow some seeds. We're going to add about 6 grams of fertilizer and then start watering. Anything up to 250 liters of water. That's another 28 grams of CO2e. Our grain is now nice and tall. We go to harvest it and we send it to the mill to convert it into flour. We'll add some sugar, we'll add some salt, and a little bit more water, and bake that bread. That's another 20 grams of CO2e. So before this slice has even hit our toasters, we've produced over 86 grams of CO2e. Now that might not seem like a lot, but here in the UK, we are wasting 24 million slices of bread every single day. That is the equivalent of 450 of you watching here today taking an around-the-world flight on a daily basis. But it isn't just slices of bread we're wasting. Every single second, we are wasting 40,000 meals. And this means that food waste accounts for 10% of the world's greenhouse gas emissions. And as a result, food waste is feeding climate change. But I'm not here to tell you to stop eating. Quite the opposite, actually. I think we can eat our way out of the climate crisis. Well, not quite literally. I mean, I'm not suggesting we start loading our plates for breakfast, lunch, and dinner, but rather that reducing food waste is the number one action we can take as individuals to limit global warming by 2 degrees by 2100. And it isn't just me saying this. No, it's the scientists over at Project Drawdown who recently compiled a list of the most effective actions we as individuals can take to reverse the effects of the climate crisis. And they found that reducing food waste is top of that list. It is the number one action we can take because it is the most immediate, most impactful, and simple action we can take. It is more immediate than switching to an electric vehicle. It is more simple than transitioning to a plant-based diet. It ranks above thermostats or smart thermostats and above LED lighting. But I'm not suggesting we don't do any of these things. We should still try. But if there is one thing you leave with today, I hope it is that you remember that reducing food waste is that number one action you can take. So, are we feeling inspired? Are we feeling fired up? Hopefully, maybe. Or are you feeling, you know, what can little old me do in the midst of this climate crisis? In the midst of this chaos, of this waste? Is this not the responsibility of governments, of the food industry, of big business? And partially so, but over 50% of food waste is happening in our very own homes, which means that we can be part of the solution as well. You know, we can start by better understanding date labels. You know, we can look, smell, and taste our food, not waste it. We can start planning better. You know, reverting back to a classic shopping list where we buy what we need and we eat what we buy. You know, storing our food better. In a nation of tea drinkers, we can place our milk on the shelf of our fridge as opposed to the door, so it will last longer. Utilize our freezers, which are essentially a pause button for freshness. And love our leftovers. You know, so last night's bolognese becomes tonight's lasagna. And embrace technology so we can start rescuing food. And this is where my third bag comes in. Now, I rescued this using an app I co-founded called Too Good To Go. Now, I haven't actually had a look inside, so you know, we can go through this surprise together, but the app allows anyone to rescue food from food businesses at a reduced price so that no food has to go to waste. Well, let's see, what did I pick up? I've got a delicious looking cinnamon twirl, a croissant, a fancy looking loaf of bread, and a sandwich. Now, I paid £3.50 for this through the app, and this food would have retailed at over £15. I like to think of it as my eco-calories. You know, food that is good for the planet, but it's also food that doesn't cost the earth. And myself and my co-founders, we founded Too Good To Go as a social impact business over 8 years ago. And in that time, we have amassed a community of over 80 million consumers, spanning 2 continents and 17 countries, alongside 130,000 food businesses who collectively have rescued over 270 million meals from going to waste. That's 3 meals every single second. And to me, this shows the power of a community, that the single act of rescuing a meal has the capacity to create impact at scale. Think of it this way. If you were to rescue a meal every single day for a year, it would be the equivalent of driving from here in the UK all the way to Athens. Remember, food waste is feeding climate change. Let's rescue a meal today. Thank you.